You could probably fit 69,000 people in there, transport them across the country.
Oh, it's a beautiful day. It's one of those days where you get burnt because there's a breeze and you don't realise you're getting burnt.
Look at that ass. I've been really trying. Pose, Royce, if I ever did see one.
Like it?
Look at that booty.
We need you to promote the hustle bag when it comes out.
With that exact pose.
Yeah.
And say like as a CrossFit coach slash like Shane's in like a former affiliate owner, the one thing you appreciate the most whenever you travel is the arsenal of just cardio gear, because it's such an expense. Like every unit, every rower is like a full set of like a couple of barbells and a full set of plates, right? It's like, so when a gym's got this kind of cardio gear, you know it's like on the top tier. Thank you.
Today, team, we're starting off in the CrossFit Mayhem store. Probably gonna spend too much money.
But it's also cool.
Can I take the fridge?
This is my daughter. I don't know if Darren and Jess would appreciate this, but I'm going to pretend that she's mine.
Comes off the floor, but
Shane and I worked really hard for her.
Four stickers, a mug, four t-shirts, a pair of shorts, a jumper, a tank top.
I left a little bit in the shop, but really, not really. We'll be back, but you're only here once, right?
So what's this?
This is where they do the podcast, and there's the mural of Rich himself.
They mentioned this on one of the podcasts about how old mate there has got full send with the iPad. the whole iPad to film.
That would be an early
model too. Yeah. So senior, Rich's dad, Kayla, Rich's sister, Janice, Rich's mum, and then this is Hillary's mum.
Wow.
Do you want to go,
Janice?
This is cool.
Hey guys.
Hi Shane.
I'm just doing MTV Cribs with my camera crew.
Rich isn't the only one doing a bigger podcast episode thing on the YouTube channel. Well, I'm doing my own.
It's called Moro.
Moro.
I haven't taken
it. Hey!
Are we now broke?
No. It wasn't quite as much as you expected to spend. You got $50 spare.
See that? That's what's called responsible.
Ish. Shane, what are you drawing here?
Yeah. Rogma.
Yeah.
Yep. You want one?
Yeah, I'd love one.
Yeah. In the right direction. Oh! Yeah. Yeah. Got one more. One more to. There it is. Is this regulation or what? Is this bat regulation?
It's fine.
So pretty.
Wow.
Dude, isn't it great?
Yeah, they're like poisonous,
I think. I'm burning!
That's the problem with Shane not doing the work yet. There's no perspective on how munted we are. Like, he doesn't get it.
We should just do the long jump right.
Because no one said it would be easy. I wasn't asking. Okay, cool.
Every time you do that pose, Roy.
You literally look like Iron Man. There's only one way this is gonna go for me. Probably the most important tip in CrossFit? Coming from Royce. Tips with Royce.
So rookie error, like, is to hold the bike like this. Like, what you gotta do is you gotta grip on. So when you go on full send, you don't just come off the bike, you know?
You don't fall off the bike if you put your grips on the bike. That's good for you.
Like Kevin voice for that.
Kevin.
You know, it's like people do this, it's not good. Okay, you put grip like this, it's fine.
Ice cream.
I use Lakeland's bar. Joking aside, this is actually a really good scale, and I would probably recommend getting one of these if either that or, as you've probably seen before, I do it off the box at home and do jumping bar muscle ups off of that. If it's like smaller sets, then I can do, you know, I'll just do bar muscle ups in a workout, but whilst they're not 100% efficient, and to try and drill the correct movement and not chicken wing them over the bar, this is really helpful. So I've just managed to obviously rack up 40 bar jumping bar muscle ups, getting the transition pretty good over the top. I don't think it'd hold Royce's weight though.
So I wanted to have a treat, and we had already done stuff, but like I actually specifically wanted a Snickers. So I knew that Shane would have given me that little guilt look, as in like, do you really need that? And then I wouldn't have enjoyed it as much as what I did. So when we got home, we unpacked like the groceries, and I was like, hey, Shane, you should really go for a shower. And he like went and sat at the kitchen table, and I was like, no, like go and have a shower. And it was funny because he, like, normally he would go straight in and have a shower, but he wasn't. And I was like, oh, what is he doing? Like, the day I want him to go and have a shower, he's not going and having a shower. Anyway, I finally convinced him to go and have a shower. I was like, oh, thank goodness. Pull out my Snickers bar and just start eating it. And no one but Sammy was in the kitchen. Sammy, I was like, oh, this is all I want.
Look at this team. There's a huge dirt bike. And then look at this jazz-sized dirt bike. All of the bikes.
This is the coolest thing in here, I think.
This is my favorite thing in here. Look, it's the Rich Froning Edition Rogue. Harley Davidson.
Hillary got it in for his birthday. That is cool. He said he may never ride it again because of the kids, but it's cool to be in here. You just look at it and you're like, that's badass.
4 Echo bikes, 4 Assault bikes, 5 rowers, 3 ski ergs, 4 Concept 2s. Loads of actual bikes.
This is cool. If you do this,
there's some whiskies. And there's a load of beers.
That's cool. I was just showing the team that Rich Froning has beers in his fridge. He may not drink them.
Got a little basketball machine. Got the Rich bar. Got the Tia bar. Got a load of other cool bars. This is CrossFit.
Yeah.
Okay.
So what's this, Royce?
Well, this, you know what? I could never have trained at this barn with Rich because I just couldn't do muscle-ups here.
This is the barn that everyone's seen. This is like the classic barn, the red barn. That right there is the classic lake, and like with the water slide and.
You know what, team? Sometimes when you're like, wow, I need to pinch myself to understand. Like, anyone that appreciates CrossFit, knows about CrossFit, or anything about CrossFit, you'll be like, oh, this place is the coolest.
I got here with other worm used to live in. It's basically open, the rig, like, the, like legit rig out in the lake. It's so cool. Yeah. I swear to God, there's like 24 donuts in that. Box costs like $13 US.
I don't know.
I was like, it's like $4.50 Australian for half a donut.
I may have lied to Craig. I said seven. Can we just say seven? Just
like, what, seven?
So it doesn't look
just
like
in case he says on the vlog.
Yeah, that is pretty cool.
Yeah, it's open at 5 a.m.
5 a.m.
Apparently, people give donuts at that hour. I want that lobster.
In the middle of nowhere.
In the middle of
nowhere. It's hard to see other people living in dreams.
So we've got some people.
Do you guys
never
have,
been here before?
Sorry, the menu of like. I'll sample one of everything, please.
I'll take one of them.
Just can I have one of these? Donuts.
So how much were all of these? But open it up. Did it open?
Oh, no.
It doesn't open.
What you can't.
$10.
What you can't price in that $10. Is
memories.
The human happiness. Yeah, the memories. The memories, relationships, and experiences that will come from these donuts.
$10.
Tia said apparently this building here is the old Mayhem. Crazy. Right next to the donut shop.